हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन वेलकम बैक टू द क्लास ऑफ रवि सर, द इजीएस्ट एंड फाइनेस्ट वे टू लर्न द कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स. स्टूडेंट्स, इन आर प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द नंबर सिस्टम्स एंड वी हैव लर्न हाउ टू फाइंड आउट रेशनल नंबर्स, हाउ टू इंसर्ट रेशनल नंबर बिटवीन टू रेशनल नंबर, हाउ टू रिप्रेजेंट नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग रिकरिंग डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन इन पी बाई क्यू फॉर्म्स एंड सो मेनी थिंग्स. स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडे वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी हाउ टू रिप्रेजेंट इरेशनल नंबर्स, हाउ टू रिप्रेजेंट इरेशनल नंबर ऑन नंबर लाइन. स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर यू हैव स्टडीड ऑल दीज थिंग्स टू रिप्रेजेंट इंटीजर्स ऑन नंबर लाइन. But students, today we will learn how to represent irrational number on number line. So students, I think you have studied about Pythagoras theorem. What does the Pythagoras theorem states? Pythagoras theorem states that square of hypotenuse in right angle triangle, square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of square of other two sides. So on this basis we will represent irrational number on number line. For students, here we having few examples regarding that. We want to represent root 2 on number line, right students? So first of all, whenever the any prime square root of any prime numbers are given or square root of any numbers is given, so your target is to be what? So write that number in the square of sum of two numbers, right? First of all students, here you can see that root 2, right? So root 2 can be written as sum of square of two numbers, one square and one square, right students? So again, root 2 whole square can be written as root 1 square and 1 square whole square, right? So root 2 whole square can be written as 1 square plus 1 square. So students, these things can be compared with the Pythagoras theorem. Square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of square of other two sides. So first of all, drawing the number line over here students, suppose a number line L, right, a point O over here and a point A. Now students, sum of square of other two sides, these sides always makes right angle triangle. Sum of square of other two sides always makes right angle triangle. So students, here you can see that one side is one unit and perpendicular line, suppose AB is one unit, right students? Now applying the Pythagoras theorems to find out hypotenuse, so joining OB, right students? Now here you will write what? Consider OA. Consider OA. Because students, these things are the sum of square of other two sides which are making right angle. So students, here you can, one can be compare, let OA is equal to one unit. Right students? Then after, here you can write what? You have draw a line AB, right? Draw a line AB such that AB is one unit, right students? Now joining OB, right? Join OB. Now student, joining OB. So OB can be compared by root 2, right students? So OB is equal to, here OB is equal to root 2 OA is equal to 1 and AB is also 1. So what, students, what you have to do over here, just using the compass, I don't having the compass, just I'm using my fingers like that way, so it's become like a compass. Considering O as a center and OB as a radius, drawing arc which intersect the line L at C, right students? So C will corresponds to root 5, sorry, root 2. Root 2. So all these things you will have to write over here generally using compass, right? Using compass, right? You should using compass, draw with center O, with center O and radius OB and radius OB, drawing an arc, right? Drawing an arc which intersect line L at C, which intersect line L at C, right students? So C corresponds to root 2. Similarly students, moving to the question number 3, same things you will have to do over here. What you have to do here, you will have, here is 2, so what you have to do students over here, write down root 3, right? So it can be written as sum of square of two integers, like root 3 can be written as 2 plus 1. Okay, now students, here you can write what? Root 3 whole square. So root 2 plus 1 whole square. Root 3 square is equal to, taking the whole square of these things, 2 plus 1. Right students? So root 3 whole square. Right? This can be written as root 2 whole square plus 1 square. As per the definition, as per the theorem of Pythagoras theorem, your target to be what? Write these integers in the sum of square of two integers. So root 3 whole square can be written as root 2 whole square plus 1. In the same way students, what you have to do over here? Draw a line L, right? A point O over here and point A. The distance between OA, considering root 2, right? And the perpendicular distance AB 1 unit, right? Now joining OB, what we are getting over here? Root 3, right? Now O as a center, OB as a radius, drawing arc which intersect the line at C, where C corresponds to root 3. So all these things students you will have to write over here. First of all, let us consider OA is equal to root 2 and the perpendicular distance AB is equal to 1 unit, right? Then draw a line, it is already written over here. Now joining OB, join OB. Now the OB can be correspondence with the Pythagoras theorem, square of hypotenuse, like that way, is equal to sum of square of other two sides, sum of square of other two sides. This is hypotenuse, can be compared by root 3. So OB is equal to root 3, right students? Now using compass, O as a center, with OB radius, draw an arc, right? Which intersects L at C? Line L at C, where C corresponds to root 3. Thus, point C corresponds root 3. The same question will be question number 3 over here. Here you have wrote root 3 is equal to 2 plus 1. Similarly, students, root 7 can be written as root 6 plus 1. Now square root of root 7 is equal to 6 plus 1 whole square. So root 7 whole square can be written as 6 plus 1. So root 7 whole square is equal to root 6 whole square plus 1. Students, root 6 whole square means what? 6. Similarly, these things can be compared by Pythagoras theorem. Like OB whole square is equal to OA square plus AB square. Right, students? So drawing the number line L, O as a initial point, now OA is considering root 6, perpendicular distance between line between AB is 1 unit. Now joining OB, using the Pythagoras theorem, OA is equal to 6, AB is equal to 1. So what about OB? Root 7, right? Now O as a center, OB as a radius, draw an arc which intersect the line L at C, right, students? So C corresponds to root 7. Okay, so comparing by Pythagoras theorem, what we are getting over here, students? First of all, write down, let OA is equal to root 6 and AB is equal to 1. Therefore, what about OB? So OB is equal to root 7. Right, students? Join OB where? So using compass, O as a center, with OB radius, drawing an arc, which intersect line L at C, right, students? Where C corresponds to root 7. Thus, point C corresponds to root 7. Okay, students, now moving to the final question. We want to represent root 13 on number line. Same things you will have to do over here. Consider root 13 can be written as like that way. Root, so 12 plus 1. Now taking the square of these things, root 13 whole square is equal to root 12 plus 1 whole square, right? So root 13 whole square is equal to 12 plus 1. Root 13 whole square is equal to root 12 whole square is equal to 1 square. Now students, these things can be compared by Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem states that square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of square of other two sides which are making right angle. Again students, you having the line L, point O, and the distance between OA, considering root 12, perpendicular distance, always consider one unit. This is B. Now join OB, right? O as a, with compass, using OA as a center, OB as a radius, draw an arc. That arc intersect the line L at C, right? So C corresponds to root 13. Okay students, now here you can write what you have considered. OA is equal to root 12, right? And AB is equal to 1 unit. You have joined OB, that's why you are getting what? OB is equal to root 13, right students? These things you will have to write over here using compass. Using compass, O as a center, right? O as a center, OB as a radius, OB as a radius, draw an arc which intersect line L at C, right? So C corresponds to root 13. Therefore, point C corresponds to root 13. Okay students, I hope you have understood this video lecture. For more video lecture of this topic, this chapter, keep watching Ravi Sarji.